sir.
And my dear trainees, brothers and sisters, let me first of all congratulate you for having made it to one of the most prestigious and promising careers that this country has to offer, that is Indian Civil Service. I understand that there are officers belonging to both All India as well as Central Services present here today. It gives me immense pleasure to be able to address you today. Whenever I go to any conference, convention, meeting or gathering, and if it consists of youth, I feel immensely happy because they are the future of the country. इसलिए जब मैं उपराष्ट्रपति बन गया तब तक मैं तो हमेशा रेगुलरली लोगों से मिलते रहते थे, मीटिंग पीपल, ग्रीटिंग पीपल, टॉकिंग विद पीपल, वॉकिंग विद पीपल, ईटिंग विद द पीपल, स्पेंडिंग टाइम विद द पीपल यूज टू बी पार्ट ऑफ माय एक्टिविटी. इट वाज 24/7 एज ए मिनिस्टर, एज ए पार्लियामेंटेरियन, एज ए मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली, एज ए पोलिटिकल फंक्शनरी. आई यूज टू डू इट. आफ्टर आई बिकेम वाइस प्रेसिडेंट देन केम द इश्यू ऑफ प्रोटोकॉल, because the vice president cannot move as he likes or as he wants. So then I said, I can't live without interaction with the people. So after discussion we have evolved that I will be focusing on 5 sectors. 1, the students, universities. There are 800 plus universities in the country. So I am trying to cover one after another. So far I think I might have gone to around 70 universities in this 1 year. And then I have also decided to visit various science and research institutes across the country, because science and research is for the betterment of the humanity. You should know what is happening here, what is happening there, and what is expected from them. Mere sitting in lab or doing a research will not suffice. It must reach the land, lab to land. And third, I am also visiting different institutes like this, training institutes. Mussoorie or Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Academy, Police Academy, number of other institutes, Marri Channa Institute also earlier I came here. And then I am also focusing and interacting with the farming community, because agriculture is the basic culture of India. It is our backbone of our economy. And even today, after so much migration to urban areas, 60% of the people are still depending on agriculture. So I meet farmers, interact with them, and agriculture is in a distress. We are all aware of it. Not because of today, it's happening over the years, because agriculture is becoming non-remunerative, unviable, whatever you call. That's why attraction also, people are moving away to other professions rather than agriculture. And then the fifth one is visiting various cultural academies, institutions and cultural programs, encouraging them, because we have to preserve our culture and our heritage. One of the strong foundations of India and its civilization is culture, our heritage. That is the speciality of India. For thousands of years we had civilization developed over the years and developed a good culture. So we have to really integrate culture to our public life, wherever we are. And then I'm also interacting with the voluntary organizations who are doing some good work. There are a number of voluntary organizations, but some of them are doing good work. So I try to select them and then interact with them. So that, and then I really feel happy whenever I meet and interact with people. And this is the All India Civil Services, Central Services. They are our core of our delivery system. What is important is delivery. Finally, whatever the governments may do, the leader may do, the chief minister may do, the prime minister may do, or may come out with best schemes, make best announcements and pronouncements, at the end of the day, unless it reaches people, there is no meaning. That is the problem today before the country. I remember, I would like to tell you also, late Rajiv Gandhi, the former Prime Minister of India, he once said, if I send 100 rupees from Delhi, by the time it reaches Thiruvananthapuram or Ananthapuram, it only 15 rupees reaches, 85 rupees gone. there is a leakage in the pipe. So it was, he made that statement out of pain and agony, not for any political consideration. But nothing much could be done to improve the system. I am not saying nothing has been done. Something has been done, but not effectively to the satisfaction of the people. So keeping that in mind, we all has to focus more on delivery system. I'll come to that a little later. Every service that comes within the purview of Indian Civil Service was conceived with a purpose. Every service has its own unique character, personality, responsibility, and a specific role to play in spearheading inclusive and sustainable development. It is only when all the civil services work together in unison, complementing and supporting each other with their specific domain experiences and expertise, that India's growth story would gain the much required momentum and direction. The strong, indestructible foundation to this unity and harmony, this esprit de corps, should be forged right here in the portals of this very institution. It was Sardar Patel who foresaw the importance of a competent higher civil service. In his celebrated speech to the Constituent Assembly in October 1949, Sardar Patel had said, I quote, "You will not have a united India if you do not have a good All India service which has independence to speak out its mind." This is what Patelji has said at that time. He is the architect of these services. And country always be grateful to him for envisaging such a great service and gave it to the country. He is called as the Iron Man of India. Recently we had a statue at Narmada Sarovar, which is supposed to be the highest in the world, 2 times bigger than Statue of Liberty and bigger than Buddha statue in China and other places. Before last week, I went to Zimbabwe. The Zimbabwe president was telling me, so you come from a country which is sending man to moon. And then he said that, of course, not only man to moon and also leader, tallest in the world. So international recognition also is coming that way. Because he unified all the provinces together, 565 provinces of India. They were all princely provinces, and English people, as usual, while leaving reluctantly, they said, we are giving 3 options to all the provinces. You can join India, you can join Pakistan, or you can be on your own. That is a mischievous offer they gave. They never wanted a united India. And they also said, you cannot live together. If you leave English people, you will be totally destroyed. That's what Churchill said. So I remember recently when India or ISRO has launched a satellite for England, someone have tweeted, so you said we will not be able to live together, and now we are sending British satellite to moon. Mr. Churchill, wherever you are, see this. Like that someone has tweeted, I think it's Anand Mahindra. See, that's the intelligence of India, talent of India. So he persuaded everybody, cajoled, persuaded, and used all democratic methods to make them to come together. And he did that wonderful job without any bloodshed. That is the speciality. And we are in Hyderabad today. This Hyderabad, the Nawab entertained different ideas because wrong advice given by his lieutenants. He said, first he'll go to Pakistan. Then he said, he want to be independent. Then Patel gave him 48 hours. And then he understood. Then finally, Hyderabad is merged with India. Otherwise, you would have required passport to come here, to this institute. And this institute would not have come. That's a different matter, of course. So, nation should always remember the great man, the unifier of India. Stalwarts like Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Dr. Ambedkar, Subhash Chandra Bose, Shyam Prasad Mukherjee, Lal Bahadur Shastri, even it is Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and of course, Jawaharlal Nehru, whose birth anniversary is being celebrated today have left a lasting legacy for all of us. Their vision was of attaining true freedom for each citizen. We salute the memory of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of this country. He presented a vision, and then he started the Industrial Revolution, and he has also focused on science and technology those days itself, and laid good foundations. So we should really salute his memory today, because today is his birthday. Nation should never forget its forefathers, great leaders, who has given everything of theirs to us. That should be the practice of any nation. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru put up it so succinctly: failure is not one of ease or resting, but of incessant striving, so that we may fulfill the pledges we have so often taken. The service of India means the service of millions of who suffer. Service of India means service of millions who suffer. That's what Nehruji has said. But it's Nehru and the iconic leaders who fought for our freedom envisaged a resurgent India. They saw India as a Bharat Mata and true nationalism as the collective well-being of entire population. As Pandit Nehru wrote in Discovery of India, the mountains, the rivers of India, and the forests, and the broad fields which gave us food were all dear to us, but what counted ultimately were the people of India. People like them and me, who are spread out all over this vast land. Bharat Mata, Mother India, was essentially these millions of people, and victory to her meant victory to these people. Sometimes we say Bharat Mata ko jai. Bharat Mata ko jai means, do not mean only the photo of Bharat Mata and garlanding her, that's end of the patriotism, no. And or otherwise you shout Bharat Mata ko jai, then you talk of nationalism, you talk of patriotism. Loving India means loving and caring for all Indians. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. We are one people, we are one nation, we are one country. That feeling has to be there among every one of us. That is real patriotism. That is real Deshabhakti. Deshabhakti maane keval nara dena nahi hai. Aajkal durbhagyapurna hai, iske baare mein bhi charcha ho raha hai. Deshabhakti kya hai? Patriotism kya hai? Iske baare mein bhi charcha ho raha hai. Kuch log ridicule bhi karte hai. Patriotism kya hai? Patriotism is loving every creature. And you know the culture of India, share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. This is not of any political party's philosophy. Our Indian philosophy, our ethos over the years are share and care. That is the core. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu vasudhaika kutumbakam. The entire world is one. We are like one family. That is the feeling India always. That's why Indian civilization is surviving even today. See what happened to Roman Empire. What has happened to Egypt? Where is Greece today? Greek. Where is Greek? They are all old civilizations like us. Many other civilizations. But our civilization is still striving. And also now, again it's India's turn. India is being recognized and respected everywhere. The other day I was in Paris for the anniversary of the 100 years of First World War. There everybody, the people, when we meet and greet them and say, India, Indian Vice President, there is a smile on their face. They're all happy to meet you because of your civilization, because of the progress you have achieved. Even today in the entire world, economy is slowing down, India is moving forward. Moving forward. And if you grow at this rate, by 2025 or 30, India will become the third largest economy. This is what everybody is saying. It's not somebody's political statement. World Bank, World Economic Forum, ADB, Asian Development Bank, IMF, International Monetary Fund, Moody's ratings. Moody's ratings, not Modi's ratings. Everybody is confirming the same. Everybody is confirming the same. That is the growth. So that is India. So we have to live up to the expectations and live up to the ethos and values of our culture and our civilization, taking care of everybody. People who are in the civil service at various levels, they should aim in reaching out the people and then taking care of the people and then see to it that the benefits of development, fruits of development reach them. You may proclaim 7.4, 8% growth, you may become 9% growth, and you may say that you are having smart cities, you are having national highways, you have come telecom revolution, you have television revolution also. So many. But at the end of the day, unless the fruits reach the common man, there is no meaning of development. This is the basic principle that has to be remembered by all people who are in administration, politicians, or who are in the service. What is required is political will, administrative skill. They will succeed. Mere passing a law will not suffice. Sometime back, I remember, I think 2012 or 13, when this unfortunate Nirbhaya episode has taken place, there was, you know, in our country we have a weakness. Something happens, people will start saying, ah, bring a law, bring a law. Implement the laws now, which are there. But we have the habit. Anything happening anywhere, say, bring a law. There are enough laws. Then I said, I remember having said, I was in opposition member of parliament at the time, 12. I said, what is required is not a new bill. Bill is okay, I am not opposed to this. What is required is not a bill. What is required is political will, administrative skill, then go for the kill of the social evil. I said, it is social evil. It is a social evil that has to be tackled effectively. So similarly, as I told you, Mahatma Gandhi, Baba Saheb Ambedkar, Deendayal Upadhyaya, all of them said, they said, Antyodaya, taking care of the last man, not here, the person sitting in the last line, in the society. Antima pankti mein jo baithe unka uttan, ye bahut mahatvapurna hai, aisa kaha un logon. So taking care of the last man, any plan, any program, any activity, unless it reaches the last man or woman, there is no meaning of development. So that has to be kept in mind. And then we talk of Bharata Mata or nationalism or say Jai Hind or Bharata Mata ko Jai, Harek Bharatiya ko Jai Ho. Ye amara mukhya uddesh hai. Ye manasikata man mein hamesha hona chahiye. And we should not fight among ourselves on the basis of caste, religion, region and other language and all. You should feel proud of your language. You must promote. I'll come to that later. You must also feel proud of your native place. All, no problem. But at the same time, we should remember that we are all one. We are all one. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka viseshata. We have 760 languages. We have so many religions, sub-religions, we have caste, so many. We have also so many gods. There is no dearth of gods in India. That's why there is no quarrel. If somebody says, one more god, add 30 crores plus one. No problem. Some people also say, aham brahmasmi. There are some people who claim that they are also gods now. Okay, namaste. For them also. For them also, no problem. That is the broader attitude of India. That's why India is still able to survive, and we should keep that Indianness, that Bharatiyata alive in our minds. Instead of fighting on small things, quarreling on small things, I really feel sad, feel so very depressed sometimes when I see students fighting between eating this food or that food and all. Whatever you want to eat quietly, na? Why festival, beef festival, this festival, kiss festival? You want to kiss somebody? With the permission, both of you go and do it. But why do you do it? Why do you do it in public place? Why do you do it in university? Why do you do it in your institution? And why do you have then beef khana, nahi khana? Then, these are all things, you see, these things should be curbed. Freedom has been given to us. Everyone has got a right. You have got a right, but at the same time, don't hurt the sentiments of other people, going and in front of them, doing something and all. That should not happen. The society has to be guided. These are all happening because of divisive tendencies that have come from some certain areas. The public administration is one such instrument for achieving the larger objectives. This is the role that civil service has been mandated to play, providing better service to the people efficiency and effectively. Efficiently and also effectively. Here, over the last 70 years, officers of the All India as well as central services have played a crucial role in national integration and national development. They are seen as the steel frame that harmonizes the social, cultural, linguistic, religious and economic differences in the country. The unfinished agenda before us is to reach out to people who have not yet been benefited from Swarajya, some of the people. In other words, we have the most important role in translating Swarajya into Surajya. Amara Purvajo ne kaha, ek bar Swarajya aaye to sabhi samasyaon ka samadhan hoga. Magar Swarajya ko Surajya ke roop mein badalne mein hum pura success nahi ho paaye. We succeeded to some extent, but not fully extent even after 70 years. That is the challenge before us. The fruits of development must reach each citizen and person in this country must feel that there is a perceptual improvement in the quality of life. This is possible only if governance becomes corruption-free, citizen-centric and business-friendly. There is also a problem in this country because of other models. Nay, business means to keep their distance from them at all. Why? Business, agriculture, industry, they are all part of our life. Business adds and creates wealth. There has to be proper business, huh? There has to be proper politics, there has to be proper service. Why you are attaching only speciality to business alone? Some people have the weakness also. They condemn business in the daytime and do business with them in the night time. Particularly some sections of the politicians. See, I have been in politics for a long time. Now I am out of politics. I am retired from politics but not tired from public life. So I would like to communicate to the people my views on various important this thing. So corruption free, citizen centric and business friendly, that has to be the objective. You must learn from the best practices within and outside India, from both the private as well as the public sector, and strive to reform outdated government practices. Often you don't have to reinvent the wheel, you would just need to adopt and scale up best practices. There are best practices. And now we are living in an era of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. If you use LPG properly, you can cook food and you can also run a motor. If you mishandle LPG, you know there will be a blast. So we have to understand the system and the present challenges and opportunities and follow the best practices, whatever available now. With the technology, what is happening here is known in France a few hours, and what has happened in France is known here or in America. So keeping that in mind, we must follow the best practices. A lot of good work is being done in the country by officers like you. If and when you feel that there are insurmountable obstacles before you, do study the examples and lives of those who have fought against odds and succeeded. You are inheritors of a glorious legacy. There are many IAS officers, IPS officers, IRS officers. We have a lot of Forest Service officers, Foreign Service officers. We have done great job. They created certain standards. There is some decline. That is worrisome. But at the same time, there are great standards set up by great people in spite of problems. So always try to follow them. Remember them. The hopes and aspirations of the country rest upon your able shoulders. Under such circumstances, you just cannot afford to remain static and let complacency set in. You cannot be bogged down by the tendency to adhere to status quo. Chalte hai, chalte ka naam gaadi, aisa nahi chalega. Civil servants should be flexible, adaptable, open and dynamic. You must be agile and proactive. You should forever remain connected to the pulse of the common man. And you are also expected to serve. You must be active, you must be dynamic, you must be fresh always, you must be receptive. People come to you with their problems, and if you start pouring out your problem, I'm not feeling well, I'm affected by diabetic, I'm planning to go to Tirupati, then he will say, sir, I'm also planning. Let both of us go together. He is coming to you for some relief with a grievance. You must be receptive. You must receive him with a smile. After all, they are our masters, they are our people. You should not think that you are a collector, you are an SP, or you are some forest officer and these are all ordinary people. No, they are the people. They are our gods. We have to really cater to their aspirations. So that should be the positive attitude, receptive attitude. If you have it, then you will succeed. Then agile, the words which I used also are carefully chosen. You have to be fresh. You must have to be dynamic. For that also, we must take care of our health so that we can later take care of the health of the nation. And if you have health, then you can acquire wealth. But there is no guarantee if you have wealth, you will have health. Wealth will not bring health, but health can bring you wealth also. Keeping that in mind, we should, because of changing food habits, lifestyle changes, a lot of problems are coming now. We must set example before others, and then we must guide other people also. People always look at collector, SP, or the senior officer. They look at them and then they try to get inspiration also. Civil servants should be, that's why they should also be flexible. They should not be rigid. They should be adaptable, open and dynamic also. Today's citizenry is an awakened one. Forget those days, people do not know anything, that you know everything. Now there are people who know more than you also, and more than me also. There are people now. And India, knowledge, there is no dearth of knowledge. There is awakening because of increase of educational levels also, and because of communication, because of technology advancement and all, there is awareness among the people. They are connected to the world through technology, and they know about developments taking place elsewhere. They expect better services from the government. Expectations are very high. People earlier used to give governments 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. Now 5 years also, people are watching government and saying, "Bhai, apne ye kaha, ye kaha, ye kaha, ye nahi hua, wo nahi hua, ye nahi hua." Then you say, "No, I have taken to Chandra Mandala." Then they say, "When are you going to Surya Mandala? Tell me that." That sort of expectations are very high among the people. See, they are not merely recipients of welfare of dole outs. They are equal partners in the efforts to improve their own lives. They wish to have a say in matters that decide their own fate. Bureaucrats should therefore be receptive and willing to include the common man in the decision making and setting development agenda. And also new dimension has come, involve the people. This Prime Minister is focusing more on involving the people. Because over the years we developed an attitude, everything will be done by the government. Sabkaam sarkar karega, am bekar baithe to chalega. Aisa nahi chalega. Aisa nahi chalega. You have to involve the society, then only schemes will be successful. For that you have to be transparent. For that you have to be really accountable. For that also you have to create awareness among the people. You must motivate them. These things can be done by the civil servants. Our efforts in direction of ease of doing business, including cutting down as layers of regulations, will not be able to deliver outcomes without changes in thinking and functioning. Please remember that unless we change how we think, we will not be able to change what we do. So there has to be change in the attitude. Sometime back, Bill Gates met me. He was discussing with me. I was Urban Development Minister at the time in charge of Swachh Bharat. He told Mr. Naidu, issue is not money alone. Issue is mindset. Mindset. Our desh mein purana parampara maloom hai. Toilet mein jana, bahar jana hai, to maidan mein aram se. Kya hai? So slowly, the mindset has changed. Now mindset is changing. I remember when the Swachh Bharat was launched, I was minister, Prime Minister told me, "Venkaiah ji, isko sarkari karyakram nahi banana, isko rajnitik roop nahi dena." Mujhe Senka aaya, man mein, rajnitik nahi hai, sarkari nahi hai, to hai kya? To Pradhan Mantri ne kaha, isko ek jana andolan ka roop dena chahiye. We should make it a people's movement. Now it's becoming people's movement. People's movement. My granddaughter, who is studying in Sanskriti school in Delhi, she told me, when they are chatting and walking, one girl, after eating the chocolate, she was trying to drop the trapper down. The other girl caught hold of it and said, "Hey, Swachh Bharat, Modi." This is the awareness even among the children also. So this is what is expected. For that you have to motivate. I have seen characters. Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Swachh Bharat, Mandya character, Koppal character in Karnataka. They have set examples. Lot of initiatives they have taken. They worked with the people. Motivated. I am giving only a few names. A lot of characters across the country, officers across the country, they have done wonderful work. But India is huge. You can't go by few success stories and all. So the civil service should be also act as ambassadors of progressive thought. process. A number of problems can be tackled by changing the mindset of the people. Behavioral change communication is now cornerstone of a number of government programs and policies. Who is the best? Someone asked, who is the best commissioner? I said, who's the commissioner? Municipal commissioner or police commissioner? I said, municipal commissioner is one who is there on the roads at 5 o'clock in the morning. And police commissioner is one who is there on the roads after 10 o'clock in the night. They make everybody to sleep, then only they should sleep. They wake up before others wake up to make things comfortable to the people. That should be the attitude. There are a lot of issues because as influencers, as people who are emulated and often followed by the society, civil service officers should also pay close attention to reforming attitudes and outlooks of the society. Real issues such as illiteracy, ill health, poor quality of education, lack of clean drinking water, sanitation facilities, poor urban planning, inadequate attention to environmental pollution, and a host of other issues continue to pose formidable challenges. Untouchability, poverty, economic disparities, gender discrimination. This is a country where we have such a great tradition. The name of the country, we call often among ourselves, we say Bharat Mata. Bharat Mata ko jai. That is the respect we give to women. And the country also, we call it as motherland, not father's land. That is the respect we give to women. All the rivers in the country, Narmada, Tapati, Mahendra Tanaya, Krishna, Godavari, Kaveri, all named after women. That is the tradition of this society. But unfortunately, certain aberrations have come and now we start discriminating. Hey, to Mahila, inke dwara hoga nahi, sir. Sab. You have best characters, women. You have best officers, sir, ministers also. We must give an opportunity, not then only. Someone told me, sir, you were talking of reservation for women. See what happened to reservation in panchayats, municipalities. I said, kya hua? He said, dekhiye sir, ab ek bar aaiye, Bihar aaiye, Uttar Pradesh aaiye, Madhya Pradesh aaiye, yahan aaiye, wahan aaiye. I said, kya bhai, batao. Nahi sir, wo aajkal sir, wo panchayat meeting mein, panchayat sarpanch pati aake baith rahe, sir, pati aaye. मैंने कहा कुछ दिन उनको मौका दे कुछ दिन होने दे पति का गति क्या होगा आपको समझ में आएगा मौका देना चाहिए बस गिवन अपॉर्चुनिटी देन ओनली दे विल बी एबल टू एक्सेल दैट हैज टू बी द एटीट्यूड हैज चेंज दैट हैज टू कम यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एंड थिंकिंग इट ये तो हमारा ट्रेडिशन है महिला घर पे ही बैठना किसने कहा घर पे बैठना गार्गी मैत्रेयी इवन दोज डेज They used to come and argue in open. Those days, I'm talking of Vedic period and also Upanishad period and all. You have seen a lot of examples of Kalpana Chawla. You have seen now examples of success we are getting at international sports and all. It's all mostly because of girls. So we must give an opportunity. So this attitude has changed. Bachchi ko school mein nahi bhejna. Padke ja karna kya tumko? Jaldi unko shaadi karana. Yet these are all attitudinal changes that are slowly changes are coming. I'm happy when I go around the universities, when I as a vice president and I give medals. Normally 1,800, 600 people, you can't expect the vice president to give degrees to all. So nowadays what they do is, all this is done by chancellor or vice chancellors, but vice president will give gold medal or distinction medal. They will make some arrangement like that, 60, 70, 80 like that. So I found to my surprise and pleasantness, that most of these recipients of the gold medals are girls, including even AG MSc, Agriculture MSc and Agriculture BSc. So if you give an opportunity, and girls always definitely excel because they have no problem, they have no tension, they have more attention. So that's why they're able to do their job comparatively better. I'm not trying to undermine the boys. Boys, of course, they have their own capacities. So keep that the need for change of mindset. I would like you all to mind four silent aspects that you should adopt in guiding principles. Empathy, mere sympathy will not, empathy. Efficiency, impartiality and incorruptibility. This will enable each one of you to emerge as effective, responsive administrators. You can make a difference in the lives of people through your work. The country expects you to become transformational managerial leaders from mere administrators. The Prime Minister gave a three-line advice. He said, reform, perform, and transform. Transform the nation. That should be our motive. Transformation. The transformation can be effectively carried by people like you who are in the service. Your small deeds may not command public or media attention, but in merit, they may equal more visible actions of those with more freedom and power. Sometimes small innovations, innumerable small steps, minute nudges and tiny pushes may usher in revolutionary changes. If ever in doubt, bear in mind Gandhiji's talisman, recall the face of the poorest and the weakest man you may have ever seen and ask yourself if the step you are contemplating is going to be any way useful to him. Will he gain anything out of it? Will it restore his control over his life and destiny? Will it give him Swaraj? You will find your all questions answered. This is what Mahatma Gandhi said. Should be the guideline. Do you do your duty with full commitment and dedication? Do it honestly and do it joyfully. Do it without fear or favor. You must enjoy. Otherwise, kya hai bhai raat ko 10 baje, 11 baje, phone aare, disturb ho rahe. If you have that attitude, you cannot enjoy at all. I have my own experience in public life. I've been going around. I have covered all the districts in the country number of times also. And I enjoy it working. I don't get tired. You are tired only when you are retired. I tell my officer, sir, too much program. I said, bhai, rest only if you are under arrest. Otherwise, no rest. you have to move on and you have to serve the people. Then you will enjoy it. If you enjoy what you are doing, then you will be able to do it more. If you don't enjoy and you start counting, 10 baje ho gaya, patni ghar mein kya kar rahe, wait karte honge, inka kya, bachon ka kya, then you will not be able to do justice to your job. So you have to really get that mindset, I have to work more, like that. See, let me recall Nehruji's vision. Today is, as I told you, his birthday is a vision of the people-centered governance and scientifically advanced nation. Let us internalize the invaluable wisdom that legends like him and other leaders have passed on to us, each of them a shining star in ferment of India's illustrious history. Let me recall what Nehruji called to the nation at the inaugural ceremony of the Bakra Nangal Dam in 1954. When we undertake a big work, we have to do so with a large heart and large mind. Small minds or small-minded persons cannot undertake big works. This is what Nehru has said. I quoted some of these things extensively from Jawaharlal Nehru today because his birthday. And also he is also our first Prime Minister. And we must, as I told you, respect all our leaders. And there is again in media nowadays, you talk more about this means, oh, he converted into Nehruianism. And then you talk about other, no, they are now trying to adopt Sardar Patel and all. Or they are trying to apportion. Sardar Patel belongs to nation. Nehru belongs to nation. Shastriji belongs to nation. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee belongs to nation. Ambedkar belongs to nation. They do not belong to one particular party. This has to be understood. They are national leaders. So keeping that in mind, whatever good is there, we must give fair treatment to all leaders. It is such a great country, you have such illustrious leaders who have guided you. And you have regional leaders who are national leaders. Some people call them as Alur Sitaram Raju, or Bhagat Singh Punjab se, yahan se ye, wahan se Narayan Guru, Basaveswara, or Veera Pandya Kattabomman from Tamil Nadu. Vivo Chidambaram Pillai, Subramanya Bharati, Shankar Dev, all these great people, they are all national heroes. But unfortunately, these national heroes were not given enough importance over the years. And confined them saying that they are leaders of so-and-so region and all. That's not correct. That's not a correct approach. See, the public administration becomes a sublime task and even small deeds become big in their impact because they touch hearts and transform lives. I wish you all fruitful session here in this institute and a purposeful success career ahead. I would like to take this opportunity to compliment the progress of Marri Channa Reddy. This also I don't understand MCR, HRD and all these things. We should also go for the real name. Real name. You find on the streets, MG Road. What is MG Road? Mahatma Gandhi Road. Mahatma Gandhi has become MG. Then you have here in Secunderabad, SP Road. I thought first it is named after Superintendent of Police. Sardar Patel Road. This is not good. We must remember. That is the real tribute to the people. LB Nagar. There is LB Nagar here. Lal Bahadur Nagar. Great man. And you make it short. We should really take their full name. Is it difficult? I don't think it is difficult. It is not difficult at all. So keeping that in mind, we should follow it. And then finally, I have few suggestions. That is one is about five things should be remembered by everybody. This is my most favorite thing. I am telling everyone everywhere, students and all. One, everybody should remember their mother. Mother includes father also, of course. Woman. Woman means W-O-M-A-N. Man is there in woman. Note that. Second, because who has given you the beautiful birth? Second is the Janma Bhumi, the native place where you are born. You should never, never forget it. Even if you want to go abroad also, some of you may. There is no need to go abroad because everything is there in India now. Foreigners are coming to India now. Even for kidney operation, transplantation, I was there in the other day in Malawi. There I saw the great dramatist of that country is being flown to India for kidney transplantation, liver transplantation. That's the knowledge of India now. We are excelling in many fields. But still you want to go, go. Go, learn, yearn and return. Come back to serve your motherland. So first mother, then Janma Bhumi, native place. Third one is mother tongue. We should feel proud of our mother tongue. The language that has come from mother's womb. Dubi Bhasha ho, Telugu ho, Tamil ho, Kannada ho, Malayali ho, Marathi ho, Punjabi ho, Assami ho, Bhojpuri ho, Kashmiri ho, Dogri ho, Dubi Bhasha. Amara Bhasha, jo matru Urdu bhi ho, amara maa ka se aaya ho, amesha usko yaad rakhna chahiye. Aur garva mehsus karna chahiye. Speak in our own language at home. Why should a son talk to his mother in English? Or a brother talk to other brother in English? Or other language? I am not against English. English also will be useful. But first, why should we first forget our culture, our language? Because culture and language go together. Bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. Bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. So that's why the colonial rulers, wherever they have gone, I've been to Latin America 1-2 months back. To Guatemala, to Peru and to Panama. To my surprise, none of them remember their mother tongue. I asked them, what happened? Sir, Spanish came and our language got vanished. It's a pity. That should never happen. I was there in Paris, my dear young friends. Paris, I was there. I had an occasion to meet a number of world leaders. And they were all addressing the meetings. None of them spoke in English. Every one of the French president was speaking in French. German chancellor was speaking in German. Russian prime minister, president was speaking in Russian. And there is a translator. Even privately also. Putin, president of Russia, he knows English. Then I was talking to him. There is an interpreter standing and then he is just hearing her and then saying something. And she is translating what I am saying. I asked Sushma Swaraj some time back. Sushma ji, kya in logo ko angreji maru nahi kya? She said, so many of them know, but they will never speak in English. They will feel proud to speak in their mother tongue. That is the importance. Mother tongue has to be protected. And then I told you mother tongue is like your eyesight. Other language is like your spectacles. If you have eyesight, then you can improve your foresight. If you don't have a sight, even by wearing, what is that, ribbon glasses. Ribbon, huh? You will not be able to improve your sight. So feel proud of your mother tongue, but don't quarrel with others on that. And then, motherland, the country which has given you this beautiful opportunity, should always remember. Country means all people. And fifth, Guru, the Guru who has given you the Jnana, the knowledge, who taught you, should never, never forget him. In spite of all this technological advancement, IT and IT becoming beauty and then making it a duty and you will become IT also, but still you need to remember your Guru who taught you. Even to run Google also, you need a Guru. It's not that machine is doing automatically, somebody is also feeding there also, na? So I always tell, Google is very important. But Google can never replace Guru. Always remember Guru also. These are all important things one has to remember. Learning language, learn as many languages as possible. You learn Assami, Punjabi, Dogri, Kashmiri. Because you have to speak with the people. You simply by learning English alone, you cannot. How many people know? For example, you are in Telangana. Gaam mein jaiye, aap angreji mein baat karenge.
उनको समझ में आता नहीं. ही वॉन्ट थिंग्स टू बी डन इन हिज लैंग्वेज. सेम इज द केस. ऑल इंडिया सर्विस पीपल शुड लर्न एज मेनी लैंग्वेज एज पॉसिबल. यू कैन ऑल्सो लर्न इंग्लिश ऑल्सो. आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम. लर्न इंग्लिश नो प्रॉब्लम. बट डू नॉट इग्नोर यूर मदर टंग. सम पीपल से सर इफ यू डोंट नो इंग्लिश यू विल नॉट गो अप सर. आई सेड गोइंग अप. गोइंग अप के लिए भगवान ने कोई लैंग्वेज रिस्ट्रिक्शन रखा नहीं. Everybody will go there. He knows that language and we also know at the end of the day. No, sir, going up. Then I told him to, I always try to give local examples, speak in my ordinary, what you call a rural language, because it will easily catch the imagination of the people. I tell them, I said, someone asked me this. I said, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu never went to convent, became chief minister. Mr. Chandrasekhar Rao never went to convent, became chief minister. Then Abdul Kalam, the great scientist, went to convent initially. He studied like me also in a street school. Our Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi, he never went to convent. Then I, Vice President of India, I never went to convent, but still has reached this position, being a son of a farmer. I used to walk 3 kilometers a day to go to school during my childhood. Studied in a street school. What we call in our language, Vidi Badi. Vidi means street, Badi means school. So that's not the question. How effectively you have utilized that occasion to acquire your knowledge, that's more important. So learn other languages also. Mujhe yaad hai, bachpan mein humne Hindi virodh andolan kiya. Baad mein samajh mein aaya, arre kitna galti kiya humne. Mera gaam Nellur, Channa ke bagal mein hai. Thoda Channa ka influence tha, IIT Hindi. So ek din hum gaye school mein, sab logon ne kaha, aaj chutti hai. Maine kaha, kya chutti? एंटी हिंदी हिंदी डाउन डाउन हिंदी डाउन डाउन. तो फिर हमको शंका आया, भाई हिंदी है ही कहाँ हमारे गांव में? किसी को डाउन डाउन कहना है तो उनके सामने जाके किसी को डाउन डाउन कहना है तो उनके सामने जाके, नहीं तो उनके इंस्टीट्यूट के सामने जाके डाउन डाउन कहना है ना, अदरवाइज वो इंस्पिरेशन आएगा नहीं. तो हम आपस में चर्चा किया, भाई हिंदी है कहा, एक दूसरे की ओर देखने लगे, हिंदी है कहा? तो एक लड़का ने कहा, नहीं नहीं है हिंदी हमारा. कहाँ? दो जगह पर है. तो उन्होंने कहा, एक रेलवे स्टेशन में है और एक पुलिस पोस्ट ऑफिस में है, डाक घर में है सब. तो हम दो बैचेस होके पुलिस रेलवे स्टेशन और पोस्ट ऑफिस जाके उसके ऊपर तार लगाया हिंदी के ऊपर. बाद में जब दिल्ली आए 1993 में, मैं मुझे समझ में आया, और हिंदी डब्बे के ऊपर नहीं तार लगाया मैंने, मेरा चेहरा के ऊपर तार लगाया. बिकॉज यू कैनॉट प्रोग्रेस विदाउट नोइंग द लैंग्वेज विच इज नोन टू मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ पीपल इन दिस कंट्री. So this is the importance of the language. So learn as many Indian languages as possible. Start with mother tongue. And then learn English also. Then learn French. Then Russian. Then German. All language. Chinese also, no problem. Learn. Because this China is such a big nation. One day you may have to do business with that. But first of all, after all this, I was given an assistant there. And I was interacting with all these leaders of the world community. One boy came, I think his name is Abhishek something. He was fluent in many other languages also. He was trying to call some Zambia president, this man, that man, and then speak in African language, then speak in French. Good. But all are not going to be Abhishek, na? So our basic thing is we have to serve the people. So please remember, practice mother tongue. I would like you to take every work you do in the right spirit. It's a commitment to serve. It's a dedicated offering of our knowledge and wisdom at the feet of Mother India. It's a ceaseless effort to excel. If one does the work with this perspective, by the public administration becomes a sublime task, and every small deed becomes a big in their impact because they touch hearts and transform lives. I wish you all the fruitful stay here. Issue with the food is not a big issue, though it is an issue undoubtedly, but. Food comes later, na? First food for thought, then food for belly. This institute has grown as one of the best academies for training public servants in India. It was started in, I think, in 1976. Over the years, it has produced several outstanding civil service officers who have proven their mettle across domains. The sprawling campus, the distinguished faculty, and the state-of-art infrastructure make Marri Institute perfectly poised to become the academy of choice for higher quality training interventions that prepare government servants to face the fast-paced changes in the world. I wish the academy all the very best. I hope it keeps strengthening its already long list of illustrious alumni. And then I wish you all the best in your future. and I convey my good wishes to all of you. God bless you. Jai Hind. Namaskar.